Good day everybody. In this video I would like to explain how to analyze data from unconfined compression test and what kind of information we can get from it. If you still don't know how to conduct this test, please watch my video. There will be a link in the description. So when we perform this test, we're gonna get a curve like this. So here you will see that we plot as a stress. We apply stress, we slowly increase the stress until it reaches the peak value, and then we also measure the strain. So from this curve, what we would like to know is this maximum value, maximum stress that this rock can withhold. And we also would like to see this linear part of the curve that would give us what we call the modulus of elasticity, or it's also known as Young's modulus. So now let's look at some laboratory data, and then we'll see how we analyze the data and how we can actually get this Young's modulus, right? So let's look at these results from unconfined compression test. So in this case, we see that we load the sample and it deformed. So we increased the load, so the strain increased, right? So this is a very typical laboratory data that you get from the test. And what we need to do is to plot the curve. So the one that I have here, I'm going to explain how I get this curve. You will see that here we have strain. And actually strains comes from this column. We don't change anything. So what we need to change is the load to stress. You see a load is in kilonewtons and stress in megapascals, right? So you probably already know that one. If you don't know, then please watch my other videos. That stress, it's the ratio between the force that we apply to the area. So in this case, we know that we use a cylindrical sample. It was a core sample with a diameter of 50 millimeters, right? So once we know the diameter, we can estimate the area. So in this area, well, you should know this one. Otherwise, just Google it. So it's radius squared. Then we have 3.14. Times, and the radius will be 25 in the power of 2. So that will give us approximately 1.9625 square millimeters. And because we use newtons, we'll have to convert it to the meters. And to convert it to the meters, it will be 0.0019625. Okay, and let's not forget units. So now we know the area in meters and we know the load. So for example, for this point, we can estimate the stress. Will be 26 kilonewtons and divided by the area, and the area is going to be the same because we don't change the diameter of the rock when we test it. 9625, so that will give us what? So that will be this point, right? So this point, approximately 13 MPa. Well, you can do it either by hand or you can use Excel spreadsheet. So that's what we do. We convert load to stress and then we plot it, right? So we put these points, they're all here. So each point here, there, right? So you'll see that it's very common for rocks. You will see a very low range of strain. Here's even in percentage, you will see 0.05% is very, very low. So this means that the rock is pretty hard and the rock will show brittle behavior. Then it's gonna reach the peak. So So the stress, it's about 60 MPa. So 60 MPa will be the maximum stress that this rock can withhold. So in this case, we can say that unconfined compressive strength of this rock will be approximately 60 MPa. Okay, now let's see how we can estimate the modulus of elasticity or youngest modulus. So what we'll need to do is we'll need to look at this straight part of the curve, because that's going to be the elastic deformation. So it's approximately here. So in this case, stress will be about 43 MPa, and well, strain will be about 0.05%, but because we're going to use strain, we just have to make it without percent, so we remove percentage, so it will be 0.05. Okay, so what we're going to do next, basically we're just going to look at this inclination of this curve. So in this case, you will see that the youngest modulus, and we use E, it's equal change in the stress to change in epsilon, which is strain. So in this case, 43.3 divided by, just make sure it's not percentage here, 0.05. That will give us approximately 86,600 MPa, which is will be about 86.6 GPa. That's pretty high, right, for this rock. And it looks like it, because you will see that the strain is pretty low when we apply the load. Well, this is how we analyze data from this test. I hope you learned something. Have a nice day, and bye everybody.